Hi friends, we'll be back into this new video tutorial with OSP Pro. In this short video, I'm going to be walking with you, showing you how you can come up with your nice simple. Just simple for now is just like, you know, just pointing to a one on us routing in React. You know, this routing. If the page is not there like so, it just don't display anything. Get? But if the page is there like that, we can display page on your React page. So this is just a complete basics of our third video. So let me just walk with you shortly, very fast, on how I came up with that, by we coming in and making up our own things and learning how can we route like this. So let me just start with this. I'm going to pause this on off. I'm going to start with saying I'm going to clear up the screen. I'm going to just go back there and I just say npx create. We're going to create up our React app, and I'm just going to call it maybe my routes, no, React routes, React route sample, no. So it's going to be a sample project, and that's the name of our project. So you'll bear with me shortly as this tends to download into my PC. So when it's downloaded and done with downloading, we should be in position to have the files ready for us to proceed. So I'll get back to you shortly after this installation. So as you can see now, we're done with downloading it up, and this tells us to move to this path. So just need to go to React root example. And you know, when we say npm start, this should start up for us the app. Well, as that's doing that, I can also come back here to the folder, and we select React route example that we're going to be using in our app. So this definitely is going to launch for us the app, and I expect the app to run, as you can see. The main play is when you go back here on the browser, this should launch for you the default app that we have. Well, so if you get back to this part of the page, this inside source is the main point. That's where we're going to define our components. So inside the source is where we define our components. It's taking long to load up, don't know why, but remember the app is running, so it's still creating up the components. I don't know why my piece is taking long, but that should be done. So if you check, that's what we really have on our app around here. So that definitely gives us a chance to come up with what we need. Now if you come back here, we have the components. So inside there you can create up the files you want, like maybe home.jar.js, about.js, also have contactus.js. Now look here, when you go out there, we have something called app.js. So this app.js is only running at the moment, so I can actually disable it, go into the header section to here, I remove it off. You can create up nav if you want. You can also create nav list if you need. But that's not the point now at the moment. Remember, working with navigations, working with routing. So I believe if I save there, I should have something. There's errors coming because of this image. So if I comment there, should you see success, and if you refresh, this is what we have. Now if you also go back here on our app, we created up different files. Let me set to the home page. So home page, I just need to say import React. This imports from the React application as expected. So React application has also got a function, so you can define a function, maybe home. So there's a function home returns for us home page of our app. That's what you have to know. So this returns home page of our app. and home page of app, and down here to export the default of that very home page, like so. So inside here, let me say this is going to be home. That's home page. So definitely when I save here, there's nothing effects because I've not exported it here. But remember, for this home page to work as expected, we need to add some new modules inside here, and that's going to be, we need to add something called npm install for us, something called React Router DOM --save. So this is a good module for whenever you want to, you know, work with React, for especially your routing. So you need to React DOM to work for you there. So this still, like I've said to you, let you utilize this time around. This is a home page. So I can even add here with something called maybe paragraph, whatever. And maybe welcome to home page. Remember, that's that. And look here. So this is that. So I can actually create my div here and I paste all of this stuff of my inside div, like so, so that I have my div, maybe also with a class there called app. Now this is done with doing that. If I say again npm start, will definitely start for us the app. Now this is our home page. You could definitely just copy this. I take to about us, I just change this to about us page. So this is just about us, like so, and the same thing I'm going to pass there of our app. The same thing I'm going to copy to my contact us page. So we already know that's all fine now. Everything's good to go. So we go back inside, you can just import them. Like import home page from the components. You also import about us page from about us. Also import contact us from contact us. Now remember, all of this is good, but we shall not get success. Why? We have few things to port. Like we just added something called React DOM into our applications here, if you guys remember that. Inside here, the components. Inside here we have React DOM, which is this one here. So we need to really come back down here and try to say import. Import one on us browser. Remember, browser is part of the reactor, so you can actually import as router. We have also routes, we have route. Yes, these are some of the stuffs you're going to import in inside there, so that when this app of ours gets to start running, should I have all these things imported on it. So this is how they do it. So this pages tends to be like that. We tend to have them independently, like so. And here down, you just pass it. Yes. Now, just waiting for my PC to load up the stuff. And if you check now here, we should have our app running up. I don't know why it's taking long to load up. So this is it. So I try to pass in this stuff right here. You know, initially we had the other home. So here just pass this stuff, which is that to our app. we're passing our route. We're passing also our route, and underneath our route here, we need to pass in the path. And this time around, I'm passing the home page, and the home page element is looking for home, for the home page that we are passing in. And the home page is closed like that. So if I save that, I expect to get to errors about us and contact us. So to solve that, I'm just going to duplicate this. This is going to be about us page, and this is going to be contact us page. So this is going to be passing contact, and this is going to be passing about, like so. So that's done. Definitely, if you try to refresh this, should refresh and gives us success, as you can see. So if you check, there's nothing there. But when you pass that, it should pass for us home page, and this should pass for us contact us page. Oops, there's some errors. Wow, just need to pass it like so. Just try to check it again. Wow, so that's, so if I remove this, that's home page, that's good. If I do that, that's about us page, and that's contact us page. Now I need to show you guys how you can create links on top on navigation, so that when you click there, definitely pushes you to those default pages, and that you can do it independently from these pages. Like for instance, when you're in home page here, you can actually definitely have a route. Like I can push mine up here, and then I pass in my links. For instance, if I say link, I think you can see it's already imported, so I say 2. So this is like home page. I expect this to just point to that. You get? Okay, I'm just trying to see something. Because if you remember here, I'm trying to pass it inside the route and that. Okay, inside the class that. So inside here, I can also pass it. I can look onto where to pass it into. Because we already have this thing down on our page. And we expect this thing we're passing to be links that you're last passing them. So how about if I just do this? I pass a link, I close a link. So our link is linking to, so this definitely moves to the first page, and this can be home page, you get? And then this can be moving to about us page, which is Devastam is called about. This can actually be linked to contact, which is can be contact us page, like so. Now this is links, so I've passed their links. So if you check here, and you I hope there's no error. Good. So where did I pass it? I passed it in the home page. So if you check this, move this, pass home page, I think you can see links on top. Think you can see it takes us definitely, and definitely I could do this. I could pass in here another div. If I want to pass a div there, I give a div class called maybe app header. App header, and then I just move those stuff. Say so pass it inside that particular div. So that's how header is coming from this hub header of this hub. You get? Yes. And that hub header, if you pass in here, this is what we have. Well, but if you refresh, this is success, as you can see. And if you go back here and home, you have something like that, and then this is down. When you click here, I think you can see. Well, it's too big, but we can always add another thing there. I can just call to wrapper. I go there here and I add more CSS. Anywhere, you can add anywhere, like anywhere. like maybe wrapper, like so. Talk about the background. Maybe it is going to be red, and then the color of the text to be white. You can also add some padding around it. Okay, let me just put something like maybe like that. I always add a little padding to be of maybe 5 pixels. Okay, and then let me say margin to from each other, let me say 5 pixels. So this is our wrapper. It's always good practice to start with the capital letter there. So if we come back here, this is the wrapper, and that's what our wrapper is capable of doing. So if you shake back in here, if you shake, we have that, that's home page, and this is about us page. So if I go back in our page here, I can just copy this various stuff. I'll show you guys how to customize your pages accordingly. So whenever each time you try to paste that around there, it will definitely going to be importing for you, because this is home. I can see import React. I'm going to move that, and then if you look onto here, this function, before the function, on top of our function, we need also to import some few things, like our page. We need to say we have import React. No, you need to import React, and also need to import link, like so. So that definitely going to be very important to you, especially on the pages you're going to be working up with. And hope that's fine for us, and that's good. So if you really look onto, that's what we have. And if you check here, that's about us, contact us, and that's it. That's guys. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you love it. That's how you can make a nice routing in your React application. So this is a nice routing that I expect you to come up with by now in our second video. So you find that this is what I have to say. Inside your app.js, you import all the pages, you pass the routing, you pass your routes. Then inside your home page, or whatever page, inside your components, you can as well define in your pages. So I just imported those two, and I'm passing them here. Well, this is it. So this is what you have in our pages there. And look, we have this done. So if you find out this is done, this will use links on the pages you're listening. Now this, you can define them on the header section of your page or the footer section. So I'll show you that one, footer and the header, in routing, in router, in route, in React. Thanks for watching. Thank you.